All right, in Auckland this week, the New Zealand government signed a deal with the Secretariat of the Pacific Community, or SPC, to help boost development in the Pacific region.
As John Pulu reports, the fisheries sector is a concern that's at the top of the list.
A handshake offering a hand up to the Pacific. The 10-year partnership between New Zealand and the Secretariat of the Pacific Community is a new wave of preventing overfishing in the Pacific Ocean.
If you allow overfishing to just carry on, you're putting at stake the, I suppose, the whole way of life of people in the Pacific.
The tuna industry is worth $3.3 billion a year. That's more than half of the global tuna being fished out of the Pacific.
Tuna, and indeed resources from the sea, is one resource that's available to all the islands. And of course they don't have much else, and you can imagine the pressure on them to try and exploit as much as they can out of their fish stock. But you know, tuna is a finite resource, as we say. I mean, it just isn't going to be there forever.
Now the New Zealand government's getting on board to help our Pacific neighbours better understand fishing sustainability.
Now the challenge with the tuna is we must cap effort. We must stop the growth in exploitation.
Fisheries experts have noticed an increase of fishing vessels over the past 5 years, luring in Pacific nations with their big dollars, which means less tuna in the sea.
The catches in these fisheries have now increased remarkably over the last couple of decades. We're at about 2.6 million tonnes of tuna.
It's important that we get a balance between what the island economies can derive through charging for days or other kinds of license fees and what the industry is willing to pay.
The cost of tuna becoming extinct is something our Pacific nations won't want to pay.